to Just Vibey Vibes. Let's talk about action and reaction, or should I say ownership? Okay, today I want to talk about this because it's not a new thing, it's not something that I am just noticing, because I kind of talked about it in my self-reflection a little bit, but then let's talk about it like just on its own. Action and reaction. You have to own whatever happens in your life, because it doesn't matter. Like, even if sometimes something bad might have happened to you, if you look at it very well, you played a role in it. We all play a role in our life. Like, whatever happens, we have to take ownership of what part do we play in it. Like, for instance, you're in an abusive relationship. If you're in an abusive relationship, then you allowed it to continue. You saw signs, you stayed. Maybe you thought you're going to change the person. Maybe, you know, one thing or the other happened that made you still stay there. Or maybe you thought, oh, maybe because he begged you or she begged you, because it's not only men that are abusive. And then you thought, oh, let me just stay, you know, like, oh, she's going to change or he's going to change. You know, whatever happened, you have to take ownership of the role that you played in it. For it to have gone the way it has gone, you have allowed it to happen the way it has happened. So that's why it has gone to that extent. So we need to remember that in our life, no matter what, we have to take ownership of the role that we play in our life. I know that there are some things that are kind of beyond our control. Like, for instance, if you're studying back home in university and then maybe you're unlucky, you have one of those lecturers that want something in return for a grade, then at the end of the day, yes, you might not, you know what I mean? There's, what part did you really play? Is it like maybe looking the way you look, that was not your fault? Or I don't know. So that could be only those kind of cases that it could be that maybe you didn't play a part in it. But maybe some people can also say, but that's, I would call that victim shame. Maybe we'll say, okay, maybe you could have done this, you could have done that, or people will say, do whatever they're going to do. So in that part, yeah, obviously, those kind of things, then you didn't play a role in it, you have no choice. The person is the person that the person is. But okay, let's talk about, so what I'm trying to say here is this. Look at your life very well, and if you want something to change, like whatever you think is going bad, stop blaming other people. Your life is the way your life is because that is the way you have made your life to be. Whatever is, there are people that you can say, oh, I am poor, I'm broke, like I don't have things. So some people too don't have, but in that little that they have, they might even have less than you. They're using it to do something to get up. So instead of staying and looking for who to blame for everything that has gone wrong in your life, looking for, oh, maybe my dad wasn't there for me. Yes, your dad wasn't there for you. But now, yeah, that part is already settled. Yeah, your dad wasn't there in your life, or your mom wasn't there in your life. Or maybe you're unlucky, you lost your parents early. Yes, all those things happened. But after that, what else happened? Whatever else happened after that, those things are beyond your control. But what are the things that are in your control? You need to take ownership of that. Because this life is your life. You can't blame anybody for it. Because I realized that most people, we do this thing whereby we always blame people for anything that happens to us. Oh, you don't, I didn't complete my uni. Or it's because I didn't have money, or my wicked uncle did not do this, or that one, oh, they were so mean to me, or blah, blah, blah. But there are people too that did not finish uni and they're doing something. So at the end of the day, even if something is not going the way it should go, what are you doing? Because whatever you do at that particular moment determines what is going to happen. You know? Whatever you do at that particular moment determines what is going to happen next. So what are you doing to move yourself from here to here instead of staying there and just sitting down and complaining and looking for people to blame? Every action has a reaction. Yes, it is not always equal and opposite like in science. No, it is not. It doesn't have to be opposite. It could be parallel. It doesn't have to be opposite. They could be at the same side. But your actions will have a reaction. So all I'm saying is, what do you want in your life? How do you want to go about it? Your life, you should look at your life like it's a project, or like it's a business and a business plan. So you write your plan. So you sit down and think, what do I want in my life? Stop blaming people. If you have an uncle maybe that is well-to-do, that is not taking care of you, your uncle's money is not your money. And let's say maybe yes, your parents had money, and then maybe something happened to your parents, and now your uncle is taking over the money, and then they don't take care of it. That has happened, it has happened. Now move forward. What can you do? So what I'm saying is this: your life is your life. Take ownership of your life. Whatever happens in your life, you play a role in it. Not everything, obviously, but I'm talking about your success. You play a role in it. Yeah, that sometimes you might be unlucky, like people get dupes nowadays, but sometimes too, you got duped because someone told you that you can do something and just get 20% profit. It doesn't happen like that now. Or someone told you that you can, someone told you something that is a lie, and because you're waiting, looking for fast money, you got duped. So guess what? It is your fault. When I was growing up, I was born into a rich family. My dad had money, had businesses, and things were going well. And then he got duped. But why did he got duped? Because he was trusting someone too much. So he trusted his manager so much that he kind of left everything. Manager had the right to sign in the company account. Who does that? Anyway, the manager is his friend, but still, who does that? So then the manager can sign on things and get it done. So then my dad had this government contract. I think he was supposed to build schools and things like that. So the manager took that contract money and ran away with it. So now, because he could do that, he did that. And my dad now had to sell his company and everything that he has to be able to pay back, even though he was going to go to prison. I think then in River State, I can't remember what year exactly it was, but there was this guy, there was this serious incident. They used to announce people's name on radio. If you've not done the contract that you're giving, you will go to prison. I remember they used to announce my dad's name in the radio because my mom used to fast and pray a lot then because of that. So I'm laughing about it, but it's not funny. But that was it. But that was his action. I'm just trying to explain this, that was his action that led to that reaction, because he let someone trust someone too much. So that was why that happened. So look at yourself. What are you doing? Where you are now, you are there. You can't change that. And I am sorry. If you're not in a good position, and if you're in a good position, good for you. But whatever you are, whether you're in a good, because everybody also has their own problem. Everybody has what they're sad about. Everybody has what they're unhappy about. Everybody has something. It doesn't matter. You can look at someone's life and be thinking, oh, this person's living the best life. I wish I can be that person. But they have something too in their life that they are not okay with. So at the end of the day, remember that you are your own. You are the key player in your life. You're the main character. This is your movie and you're the star. So how are you going to act it? How do you want it to turn? You decide. You choose. And you work for it. I know you might be everybody is in a different location in their life, and some locations, things are tougher than some other locations. And at the end of the day, I know I cannot say this for everybody, if I'm being honest, but if you have data and you can come on the internet, and you can watch, then I am sure that you can do something in your life. There are so many things that are happening. People are doing, I think, TikTok videos, and they're making money. So if you have data, do TikTok. Then look for something that you're good at. You don't have to dance. You don't have to do it. There's this guy that is very funny. All he does is he debunks all those videos where people do extra stuff. And then he just goes, if I can find one of his videos, and I'm sure you must have seen, if I can find one of his videos, I'm going to put it. So when someone does some kind of things that is he will just show the simple way with his face like that, and that is it. And if he has lots of views on TikTok, I'm sure he starts making money. So look for something if money is the problem. You know what I mean? There is so many ways. Now the way things are, if you can watch me talking on this YouTube, then you can do something. Because I know that some people in some situation whereby there's even nothing that they can do, or it's so tough, they're trying, but to make ends meet is hard. But look, as much as you're trying and you keep working towards it, then you can achieve it. And as long as you also believe, because your faith is very important, you have to believe in yourself. I think I said that last video. You have to look for something to believe in. As much as you believe in God, you have to believe in yourself too. You have to believe that if you put your destiny in it, then God is going to bless you if you believe in God. But if you don't believe in God, then believe in yourself wholeheartedly. Just believe that if I put my mind to it, then I can make it work. I am that strong that my thoughts and my actions lead to something. Once I put my mind to something, I get it done. So you have to have that in you. So whatever situation you're in, I don't know, but stop blaming people. I'm not saying that people have not done it, but people are people. People are going to do what they're going to do. What are you doing? That's why I'm not saying that the people that you're blaming, maybe they're not to blame. Sometimes they're not, but sometimes they are. But they are playing their role. What is your role, and what are you playing? What are you allowing to happen to you? That is what I'm talking about. What are you allowing? You can blame people all you want, that, oh, is this one, is that one. What are you doing to change it? Or what are you doing to run away from it if it's something you cannot change? What are you doing to escape it? What are you doing differently every day? Or are you doing the same thing and expecting a different result? There are some people that all they do is, you know, like, I don't want to bash someone asking for it because you might need money to ask somebody, but if you're asking, are you looking for a way? Like, I will always say, instead of ask somebody for money for them to give to you, think about what you can do. Like, if not having money is the issue, think about what you can do to multiply it. Don't look at all this fast scheme or like all them crypto and all them sort of blah. I'm not saying that you should not do it, but all those things are not fast money. If they tell you that it's fast money, then it's fraud. Because it's things that maybe you need to invest in a longer period of time to get good money. Like, you want to buy shares, then shares, you have to take a lot of time. Like, some people that invested in Uber, Lyft, and Zoom, all those stuff years back, they have to be patient. And then now the money that they're getting is ridiculous, but you have to be patient. And sometimes you win, sometimes you lose. So I wouldn't even say that might be a good business for someone that doesn't have and is trying to. I would not say shares is not the way. That shares is for someone that has enough for each day, and then they can keep that aside. If by God's grace, if it works for them, it works for them, you know. Like, if the company grows, then it works for them. Sometimes you might have losses, but then one win could be all that you need, you know. So something like that. But look for something that you can do to change the circumstances that you're in. It doesn't matter whether it's the relationship, whether it's your life, whether it's your job. If you're working somewhere whereby maybe people are treating you so bad, people are talking to you so, you know what I mean? Like, what are you doing to let people think that they can do that to you? Because it is you. It is you. Most of the time we watch all these movies where there's someone that, you know, there's the way that they are, and then they just let anybody, so everybody knows that they can give them their job, and then they will just do it. They can give them their job. They're just piling their job for you. You didn't even be grumbling inside, but you've never told them no. Then wake up one day, think, what are you doing? Then say no. Say, I'm not doing your job. I'm not doing it. Even if it's a spirit that talks, tell them one day, if you don't like someone shouting at you, tell them, I don't like you shouting at me. Can you talk to me normally? Because when you talk to me normal, I like it so that I can answer. Because I have ears, I can hear you. I remember when I was a child, my parents did never, I said, they would never beat me, but they always shout. Like, if I do something, you know, they always shout. And I always used to think, I'm like, why are you shouting? I'll start crying then. And I'm like, why are they shouting at me? They just talk to me, I will understand. So because of that, I do that, like, with children around me. Sometimes, yeah, I do shout once in a while, but most times I sit down, I explain something to you. Like, if it's something like, why are you continually doing it like this? Well, maybe my voice might be loud a bit, but I kind of had to think about, like, okay, I will just explain things to someone instead of shouting. So sometimes you need to think, what are you doing to allow that? What role are you playing? Because it is your life. You are the star. You are the script writer. You are the director. You're the producer. So what are you doing? As long as God give you, as long as you're still breathing, you wake up and you breathe, what you do going forward is on you. So if you're unhappy, it's on you. If your work is stressing you out, it's on you. Why are you allowing it to stress you out? What are you doing? Are you an overdoer? Are you one of those people that when you go to overdoers convention, I always say that. Are you an overdoer? Are you someone that when you go somewhere, you do, you don't even sit down? Like, when it's time to sit down, you don't sit down. You forget that you have a break to maybe sit down and rest. You forget that you need to sit down and rest. You forget that you need to have time for yourself just to even think to yourself. Are you one of those? Are you one of those people that maybe you don't allow, like, okay, let's say you're the manager, but you don't know how to divide work, you know, to give people things that they are supposed to assign them to their responsibility, look at their strengths, so that you know what to give them to do. Instead, you want to do all their work. And then you come back, oh, I'm tired, but this work is so stressful. It's on you. So all I'm saying is, take ownership of your life. You are in charge. Whatever happens to you, it's your fault. Whatever way you let people treat you is your fault. If you're in a relationship and relationships, but people are treating you like shit in your relationship, and you're taking it because somehow now you believe that you cannot be loved, or you don't deserve to be loved, or you've let your low self-esteem take over, it's your fault. So then get out of here then. Get out. I've said it before, if you don't know how to do it, then go and watch my How to Get Over Heartbreak and this, and then you work on that. But get out of it. If it's a work that is stressing you, I start looking for another job. And then when you go to the next job, look at what have I done with my character this way that has made this job like this, then change it. So that those new people now don't see that, so that your work will be less stressful or less whatever it is that was stressing you out. So work on it is your life. You decide how you want it to be. So that's all I'm going to say. So action, reaction. So what are you doing in your life? What actions are you playing that is bringing those reactions that is happening in your life? What are those? Like, you know, like normal, we have chemical reaction, you put this and this together, then you get product. So it's always you. You put something together that is giving you that product. So whatever is taking out, then just change it. That's all I'm going to say. So change it. And I hope that you have a happy and fulfilled life and take ownership of everything that you have done. Anything that's happened in your life is your fault. Just think about it that way. It might not be your fault 100%, but think about that. I have to do something to change it, and then you do something to change it. And then we go from there. I hope this message comes to you well, and I hope you look into your life and see what you need to change. Please do not forget to like, share, and subscribe. I'll see you some other time. Bye bye.